Hi everyone, hope you all are doing good. So today we are going to start a new lesson, chapter number 13, Soil of India. So today we are going to learn about a natural resource provided by our Mother Nature. Yes, I told you before, isn't it? About soil. Here we are going to discuss about different types of soil, how the soil is formed, and also about soil erosion. Let's look at the mind map. Look here children, this is the mind map of our chapter. Chapter number 13, Soils of India. So in this chapter, we are going to learn about how soil is formed, then different types of soil and its features, and also about soil erosion and how to prevent it. Soil erosion and how to prevent it. First, about how soil is formed. Soil is formed due to the factors like natural factors like sun, wind, water, even the temperature. They break large rocks into smaller pieces which further break down into sand and silt. So that is how soil is formed. Then the next topic we are going to discuss is about types of soil and its features. We are going to learn about alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil, mountain soil. So these are the types of soils and also its features we will be learning. Then the next part about soil erosion. How, what do you mean by soil erosion? Soil erosion means removal of topsoil and how to prevent it. So these are the things we are going to learn from this chapter. Do you know soil is a natural resource? Yes, it is. How soil is formed? Do you have any idea? I will tell you how. The formation of soil is a very long and slow process. It takes many million years to form a thin layer of soil. Our natural forces like sun, wind, water, and even rain and also temperature, they break large pieces of rocks into smaller pieces. I told you before, it is a very long and slow process, which are again broken down, creating a layer of soil. And this is how soil formed. Now, what is the meaning of fertile soil? Fertile soil refers to the ability of soil to sustain agricultural plant growth. Fertility of a soil is measured by its ability to support growth of plants. Have you heard about fertilizers? Have you heard about the term fertilizers? Factum Post 2020, urea, potash. These are fertilizers. Farmers add fertilizers and also manure like cow dung to increase the production of crops. Let us see soils we can see in our country India. In the last class, I've told you our country India is an agricultural nation, isn't it? More than 70% of our people are engaged in agriculture. So soil is one of the most important natural resources in India. And also, in our country, we can find different varieties or different types of soil in different parts of our country. Children, do you remember where do we use this term alluvial soil? We have studied about this, isn't it? Yes, in the Northern Plains chapter. Am I right, isn't it? So alluvial soil is one type of soil. Then red and black soil also we have discussed. Where we can see these types of soil, children? Yes, in the southern plateaus, the desert soil in desert, mountain soil and laterite soil. So these are the different types of soil we are going to discuss. Do you know, children, there are 6 types of soils we can see in our country. So look here, children, these are the different types of soil and their features we are going to discuss now. First, let us see about alluvial soil. Where we can find alluvial soil? In the states of Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Odisha, Assam and some parts of Rajasthan. Children, do you remember 70% of Rajasthan is covered with desert, and in some parts of this place we can see alluvial soil. Let's see the features. What are the features? What type of soil it is? Alluvial soil. This soil is made by fine silt brought down by the rivers, originates from the northern mountains. So it is extremely fertile. And let's see what type of crops grown in this soil. Rice, wheat, sugarcane, millets, oil seeds, etc. These are the crops grown in alluvial soil. So the next soil we are going to discuss is about black soil. From the name itself we can identify that is in black color. This type of soil, black soil, is found in the states of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Tamil Nadu. The soil is black in color and contains a very high percentage of humus. It is humus. Humus means what? Humus is a substance formed from dead leaves and plants and also the remains of animals. This makes the soil fertile and the soil is rich in clay too. And this soil is also called as rigor soil. The next type of soil we are going to discuss is about red soil. It is found in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Rajasthan, Odisha, Assam, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. Do you know, this soil is rich in iron, and so that's why that color, that red color, which that iron, the soil is rich in iron, which gives this red color to this. And this is also not very fertile. Farmers add fertilizers to make it suitable for agriculture. And what type of crops grown in this soil? The crops grown here in the soil are millets and groundnuts. So that's all about red soil. Next type of soil, laterite soil. The laterite soil we can see in Karnataka, Kerala, Odisha and also in Assam. And what are the features of laterite soil? Let's see. They are it also in red color due to the presence of iron oxides. Due to the presence of what? Iron oxides. And this soil is not very suitable for agriculture as it is made of clay and gravel. What type of crops grown here? Tea, tobacco, rubber, cashew nut, groundnuts are grown in this soil. Next type of soil, desert soil. Desert soil. Desert soil, from the name itself we can identify that it's from where, which part? Desert soil, where we can see it? Yes, in the western desert region or Thar desert of Rajasthan. Yes, some parts of Punjab, Haryana and Gujarat also we can see desert soil. What are the features of this soil? The desert soil are the soil which is like very least fertile among all the other types of soil. It is porous and also it does not retain moisture. You take some sand and pour water into it. You can see that the sand doesn't hold water. So desert soil is the soil which is least fertile, and the soil is light in color with the high salt content, and it is sandy and also little bit clay. The crops grown in desert soil are date palms, barley, maize, groundnuts, sesame and also chilies. The last one, the sixth type of soil, mountain soil. This is found in the mountain areas of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and also in Arunachal Pradesh. Children, this soil is also rich in humus, which helps the plant to grow better. And do you remember terrace farming? In this mountains, people perform terrace farming or step farming. So these are the types of soil we can see in our country: alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil and mountain soil. So in your textbook you can see a map, isn't it? In this map, this is our country map, and here we can find out which place having what type of soils. Here brown in color, it mentioned about here, that we can see brown, and also here in between, these are where we can find mountain soils. And alluvial soil, this green color, this green color from here to here, this mentioned the alluvial soil where we can see. And next is red soil. Red soil here, more majority red soil we can find in these states and also these places. And next is black soil here, the middle of India we can find black soil. And laterite soil in here and all we can find laterite soil. And desert soil in this part, in Thar desert we can find desert soil. So this is a map of the soils of our country. So we already finished with the types of soils. Now we are going to learn about soil erosion. Have you heard about the term soil erosion? The top layer of the soil, do you know children, the top layer of the soil contains many minerals and in certain regions humus also. This is actually good for plants. Sometimes during rainfalls, heavy rainfalls and also when the strong winds, they remove the top layer of the soil. This is known as soil erosion. What happens then? The fertility of the soil reduces. We have to stop soil erosion, isn't it? How can we stop soil erosion? Yes, we have to do something to stop soil erosion. Yes, that is correct. By planting trees. We should stop cutting trees. And also, do you know children, the roots of the plant hold the soil firmly to the ground. So we can actually plant more trees to stop soil erosion. Think more about this. How can we reduce the soil erosion? So that's all about this chapter. Here we have learned about how the soil is formed, types of soil and its features, and also about soil erosion. So that's all about children. Study well, read the textbook. If you having any doubt, we will clarify during our interactive session. So stay safe, take care, bye.